The Bible is my hope.
It's the source of my guidance.
The Bible is my rock. It's my foundation. The Encouraging Word.
Why would God pour out so many blessings on you and me? He does because He loves us.
We all need encouragement, and we'll find it today in the Bible-based preaching of Dr. Don Wilton. The Encouraging Word.
Remember a ceremony for our fallen soldier. Please join us as we remove the black cloth of mourning and lift up the American soldier who gave all for this country. Today we gather as a nation at rest, but never broken by the loss of an American soldier for their country. This table reminds us that we are a family, but truly heartbroken for their brothers and sisters who place at the table forever be empty. The table is round, a symbol of eternal life. It offers a hope at another table where every tear will be wiped away. The white tablecloth. The white tablecloth is a symbol of purity of the sacrifice the American soldier has given for his country. The black boots. The black boots are a symbol of strength of the brave hero that stood up and faced the evils of this world. They are empty and unpolished, a reminder of the tragic event that brutally stole their shine from us. The soldier's weapon. The American hero has always taken a rifle and stood opposed to defend our nation's freedom, regardless of where or without hesitation. The dog tags. The dog tags are personal, as they represent a name of a brave hero who wore them until the service of this great nation was fulfilled. No greater love than this for a man to lay down his life for his friends. The white gloves. The white gloves are a symbol of modesty, since they serve their country with honor, integrity, and quiet dignity. The Kevlar helmet. It's symbolic of the unselfish dedication to where our American soldier serves. It's when we heard the dreaded call, man down, is when our world stopped in time. We now raise it back up with pride and perpetual gratitude. The red rose. As this rose will fade and wilt away, our brother's rose will not, as they live among a true rose now, the rose of Sharon, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. As we fold our nation's colors, let us always remember the price has been paid by the brave men and women who gave the ultimate sacrifice defending this flag. And make no mistake about her, she stands for freedom and always should be respected. You can spit on her, walk on her, burn her, but she will never lose her glory. She's filled with the strength, blood, and honor that many have fought and died for, and should always be held to the highest regards for the unselfish dedication and sacrifice that has been given for this flag of the United States of America.
Next.
Lighting of the eternal flames. Light represents life. Jesus himself said, I am the light of the world. Lighting of the eternal flame has long been a symbol of those we remember. Today we light three eternal flames. The first flame represents the brave men and women who defend our nation's freedom on both United States and foreign soil. The second flame represents the family of an American soldier who stands by their side with prayer and love and prays for the safe return at the end of each tour of duty. And the last flame can never be extinguished, for it represents the brave soul who gave the ultimate sacrifice for their country and the freedoms that we hold dear today. As we place God's word on the table, our prayer would be that God continue to watch over and protect those still serving, the families of the fallen, until we all meet again in a land where no rifle, Kevlar helmet, dog tag, table of remembrance, statues, or walls with names in them will be no more. For we all have one mission, to serve our Lord and Savior, the risen Lamb of God, Jesus Christ. Now we all ask you to join us with a prayer our Lord taught us to pray. Kneel. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Center, face. Forward, more.
I want to just speak to you for a few moments about the ultimate gifts of sacrifice. As I was so deeply honored and privileged together with each one of you to be able to sit here today and watch this outstanding presentation of the colors and this time of remembrance as presented by Spartanburg County Sheriff's Office in such a magnificent way. And I looked at them and I saw the polish with which they did this, and I was drawn into the solemnity of the occasion. And I find myself becoming very emotional at times like this. I can feel it deep down in my heart. It's like you want to cry. There's an emotion there. And it runs very deep. I believe with all of my heart that we have great responsibility to pass from one generation to another the meaning of their sacrifice. What does their sacrifice mean? I just wrote down three things that they have given to me and to you. Number one, freedom. We live in freedom. And if I were thus inclined, I could list off a whole lot of countries for you, some of which I'm very well acquainted. Crime, the anger and hostility of people, open murders and assaults, carjackings. So just think of the basic, yes, then let's get into the tenets of our Constitution, freedom to worship and freedom of speech. And we know all of it, but just think about our individual freedom. That's just one. That's what they've done for us. Second, security. We live in a nation of laws. These men and women laid down their lives, yes, for our security. The law of the land. The ability to be able to live out your life. Not with the freedom to just do whatever anybody wants to do, but the freedom to live within the context of the license that is given through the law of the land determined by the people. Another one is determination, freedom, security, determination. I think these incredible people have given to us an amazing gift, and that's the gift of determination. Determination for what? The determination to succeed. The determination to make certain that nobody takes this away from us. And so when we talk about ultimate sacrifice and a day like this, you and I can talk for hours and perhaps even somewhat debate some of the things and be reminded of the deep things that matter most. But I'm here today to tell you about the ultimate gifts of sacrifice that the Lord Jesus has given to us. And when Paul came to the end of this prison epistle, he knew that his days were numbered. In many regards, you know, I'd love to ask him one day when we get to heaven, Paul, when you penned these words from that prison in Rome, I think that you knew that you were about to be executed, didn't you? In many ways, this was what you wanted them to know, if nothing else. And everything you said in these final words pointed to the ultimate gifts that God has given to all those who accept, trust in, believe in the ultimate sacrifice. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not die, but should have eternal life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might believe, might know, might have, might be indwelt by something that they cannot do for themselves. And so it is, this is action-packed. I just share five of these gifts of sacrifice. Number one, through His sacrifice, Jesus gave us the gift of ultimate contentment. Contentment. That's what He tells us about in verse 11. He says, I've learned that in whatsoever state I am content. That's what Christ does for me. And we're living in a day and age today of increasing restlessness. People are discontent with their marriage, discontent with their family, discontent with their work, discontent with the motor car they drive, discontent with their church, discontent with their schools, discontent with their politics, discontent with the state of the military, discontent with their friends, discontent with everything. And if you look at America today, this incredible land, this beautiful place from sea to shining sea, just listen to the discontentment of we the people. Can you imagine that? Christ gave his life. You know, one thing the Lord Jesus has done for me, and he will do the same thing for you, is through his sacrifice, when you repent of your sin and confess before him and you respond to the Spirit of God, yes, you are forgiven. Yes, your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. But all of a sudden, you become content. It's a spiritual thing. Jesus' gift of sacrifice also gave us ultimate strength. I can do all things through Christ. Just look at people today. Look at us. Have you noticed us? Many of us, oh no, it's another day. I don't know if I can keep on doing this. I don't know if I can carry on. I'm so tired of the same old, same old. I'm tired of always trying. I'm tired of being at school. I don't want to do this. This is too much for you. You mean I have to go again? And life, by the way, takes our strength away. We can all understand that. I'm just telling you now, there are thousands of parents all across America today that at this point in time are so happy school's out. That'll change next week. I'm talking about this point in time. Ultimate strength. You know, the Lord gives us a strength we don't know. Ultimate friendship. The sacrifice of the Lord Jesus gives us this ultimate gift of friendship. I love verse 14. Yet it was so kind of you to share in my trouble. I love that, don't you? You know, I look out across our congregation in Genesis and here in Celebration and our people, and I just thank the Lord for friendship. Gosh. Look out, I just see one friend after another. Isn't it great? We celebrate with each other. We love on each other, but we're not just there when the sun is shining. We're really friends. We're believers. We love the Lord and we love one another. Ultimate provision. Ultimate provision, verse 19. The ultimate gift of Jesus' sacrifice was that he gives to us exactly what we need when we need it. Just think about the numbers of times that you and I come right up to the crunch line. I've always not quite appreciated it, but I increasingly understand why God lets us go all the way to the 11th hour sometimes. My God shall supply all your need. What is on your table right now? What is it that you need? God knows that. And through the sacrifice of the Lord Jesus, he provides all your need according to his riches in glory. And then the final one I wrote, ultimate contentment and ultimate strength and ultimate friendship and ultimate provision. But I love the last one. It's right there in verse 23. It is the last word that Paul said, the grace of our Lord Jesus. What a gift. Grace. God's grace is his unmerited favor. Are you ready to give your heart and life to the Lord Jesus Christ? Please pray this prayer with me. Dear God, I know that Jesus loves me. I believe that he is the Son of God, that he died for me on a cross and was raised by the power of God on the third day. I repent of my sin, confessing my sin to you and inviting you to come into my heart and into my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you if you've prayed that prayer. I welcome you into the family of God. And I invite you to pick up the phone and call that number on the television screen. We'd love to connect with you as brothers and sisters in Christ. And in fact, I'm going to come back. So don't leave whatever you do. I've got one final word for you in just a moment.
Do you feel like you've blown it in your walk with God? Are you filled with anger or bitterness? Do you have a difficult time forgiving others? If so, know this: God continues to pour out His goodness upon each of us. His grace and mercy abounds far greater than our tragedies and failures. Join Dr. Wilton as he paints a picture of how God's love and grace can triumph over any anguish or outrage in this soul-stirring message, God's Unimaginable Grace, along with a special new Christian movie called The Heart of Texas. Both of these life-changing resources will help you learn how to extend grace and mercy to others. You'll be challenged to love and forgive people in a way that will not only change you, but change your family and community with the love of God. You can write to us at Post Office Box 2110, Spartanburg, South Carolina 29304, or call toll-free anytime, day or night, at 866-899-WORD. You can also visit us online at theencouragingword.org. Thank you again so very much for your partnership in helping us share the love of Christ and spread the gospel with the encouraging word.
Oh, I love the summer, don't you? You know, it's just a great time of the year. You know, I grew up overseas where everything was turned around back. So when I was a boy, when we went into the month of June and July, we were going into the deads of winter. Can you imagine that? Always had a problem trying to figure out all the snow in December. But at any rate, that's another story. I just wanted to wish you just a wonderful summer. I know there's a lot of work going on, mission trips, activity, family. I want you to just keep strong in the Lord. Keep studying His Word. Keep seeking His face. Why don't you start, if you haven't already, just have a short devotion with the Lord Jesus every day. He will absolutely transform every day as you go through this summer. God bless you.
Our time is gone for now, but don't forget, you can ask for a copy of today's message on CD or DVD just by calling 866-899-WORD or visiting us online at theencouragingword.org. Till next time, have a blessed week.
Thank you so much for worshiping with us. You know, you might be asking that age-old question, what's next? Good question. Many of you have given your life to Christ. But that's not what's next, even though I rejoice with you. Many of you have rededicated your lives to Christ. What incredible joy. But here's what's next. Where are you going to go to church? You need to be in a Bible-believing church. You can come right here to our church if you're in the Spartanburg area. It's not about being a Baptist church or a Presbyterian church or a charismatic church, but we are connected into a variety of churches of every description, all teaching God's Word across the country. We want to connect you. Call us. We'll help you. Get connected.